Alwa's legacy is a single-player retro platformer with a download size around 1.1 gigs and should take players around 10 to 12 hours to wrap up. The game has a great combat system with special items and spells you can unlock. There are cool environmental puzzles to solve as you progress through, plus the soundtrack is amazing. The map is pretty large though, and it's easy to get lost, so keep that in mind as you explore. But if you're looking for a good retro game, Alwa's Legacy is on sale until the 29th, marked down 50%, matching a previous low of just $8.99. Axiom Verge is another single-player retro platformer. This time it has a small download, just over 300 megabytes, and again offers more than 10 hours of gameplay on average. The graphics and soundtrack are impressive, but even more so when you realize the game was made by one person. The combat is amazing, the upgrade system works well, and the port here on the Switch runs great and includes all of the content, making it great for gaming on the go or at home. Now again, you'll want to learn the map in this one for sure, but if you're interested in Axiom Verge, be sure to grab it up before the sale ends on the 21st. It's marked down 50% to just $9.99. Blasphemous is yet another amazing retro Metroidvania, however this one has more of a Souls-like feel to it with the combat system and how the enemies respawn when you save, the way you level up, things like that. Now this one has some of the best pixel art graphics, and it's truly disturbing the way the enemies and boss animations work, and the game has a hefty download around 7 gigs, but offers about 20 to 25 hours of gameplay, making it a great value, and they recently added DLC as well for even more action. If you're interested in Blasphemous, make sure to pick it up before the sale ends on August 4th. It's marked down 75%, matching a previous low of just $6.24. Cathedral is one of the tougher Metroidvanias out there. It has a great retro aesthetic combined with some modern gameplay mechanics, and it comes in with a download around 175 megabytes and will offer again more than 20 hours of gameplay on average. As with most Metroidvanias, there are a ton of upgrades and secrets to find, so you want to explore and again try to get used to the way the map works. The game is incredibly tough and a rage quitter for sure, so keep that in mind, and the game doesn't hold your hand at all too much either, so if you're ready for a challenge, make sure to grab this one up before the sale ends on the 29th. It's marked down 50%, matching a previous low of just $7.49. Crown Trick is a single-player strategy RPG from Team 17, and again it offers more than 20 hours of gameplay on average with a download size around 1.4 gigabytes. This is a great roguelike with turn-based tactical combat, beautiful art and animations, and the story is surprisingly deep as well. Now at its core it's a dungeon crawler, which is one of my favorite genres, and each run feels fresh and varies from the last, and the item upgrades and unlockables are amazing. On top of that, the puzzles are fun and the boss battles are a blast as well. If you still haven't played Crown Trick, definitely check it out before the sale ends on the 4th of August. It's marked down 70%, matching a previous low of just $5.99. Golden Force is a side-scrolling action platformer from No Gravity Games, who just celebrated their birthday and gave away 5 free games here in the month of July. Now this one is available for 2 players in local co-op, and it has a 1 GB download with a main story that should last about 5 to 10 hours to complete. You have multiple playable characters that all play a bit different from one another, collectibles and secrets to find, plus again the boss battles are pretty awesome. In fact, the game throws you right into the action against the boss at the start, and it really never lets go from there. If you enjoy a good challenge, a good platformer, make sure to pick this one up before the sale ends on August 1st. It's marked down 60%, matching a previous low of just $7.99. Monster Sanctuary is a retro RPG, again from Team 17. It has a download around 650 megabytes and should offer more than 30 hours of gameplay, maybe even a bit more on average. It's a unique combination of 2D platforming, RPG mechanics, and monster catching, and while similar to other games in the genre, there's enough here to separate it and make it worth checking out. It also has PvP, where you can battle other players online with the monsters you've captured, which is a cool addition. Now the graphics are great, it runs well on the Switch, and if you're interested in this one, make sure to pick it up before the sale ends again on the 4th. Right now it's marked down 66% and matching a previous low of just $6.79. My Time at Portia is a family-friendly simulation RPG with a download size just under 5.5 gigs, and it offers potentially hundreds of hours of gameplay due to the addictive nature of the game. If you played Stardew Valley, this game is very, very similar to that, almost to a fault, as it really does seem to be just a 3D version of almost the same game. Now here on the Switch, it released in a pretty bad state, but the devs have since released patches and updates that addressed most of the issues, and it's really enjoyable, and they've even made some improvements to the inventory, making it even more simple to play than its competition. With that said, the game is very addictive, and right now you can pick it up on sale for just $7.49, a 75% discount and matching a previous low, again until the 4th. Neon Abyss is a single-player 2D action platformer, again from Team 17, with a download size around 750 megabytes, and again the game could last more than 20 hours to finish up. It's another unique dungeon crawler where you can combine the items and upgrades you find in nearly unlimited different ways, plus each run is altered from the last. There are even multiple different endings you can unlock as well. Now the controls feel great, the combat is fast and fun, and there's even some DLC that you can pick up as well if you enjoy the base game. If you're interested in this one, make sure to pick it up before the sale ends again on the 4th. It's marked down 50% and matching a previous low of just $9.99. Overcooked 2 is a multiplayer party-style game where you can play with some friends either locally or online, with the goal being to serve all customers while dealing with crazy kitchens that warp or shift, while also avoiding hazards and making sure none of the food goes bad. It's truly chaotic, and of course with Part 2 they added in the online, which really gives the game a whole new level of mayhem and accessibility. Now this one does have a pretty hefty download, again around 5.7 gigabytes, but it offers unlimited hours of fun. It is frustrating at times, but if you haven't played Overcooked 2, it's on sale for just $6.24, a 75% discount matching an all-time low until the 4th. RICO is a cool first-person shooter from Rising Star Games with a download size around 4.8 gigabytes, and it offers dozens of hours of gameplay due to the replayability and the fact that the game has both local and online multiplayer as well for two people. It's basically a roguelike first-person shooter that plays out like a buddy cop movie and has us taking out waves of enemies, searching for evidence, and ultimately working our way up the ranks to the final boss. I definitely recommend this one if you're looking for a fun first-person shooter to play with a friend online here on the Switch. In fact, we did a stream, Snowly and myself from Snowly Games. I'll have a link down below. But right now you can pick it up with a 65% discount and matching an all-time low until the 5th for just $6.99. Alright, let's check out HunterX. This is a new release from Orange Popcorn, the same folks that made 3000 Duel, which is another amazing 2D action platformer. The game has amazing graphics, smooth gameplay, and it's just as fun as 3000 Duel, if not even more. Now it does have a download around 1.4 gigabytes and requires no day one patches to run the way it does on the Switch, which is always a plus. The combat system, the way you level up and work through the skill trees, it's all very similar to other Souls-likes, and the game has really been a blast so far. We did a live stream here on the channel, and right now if you decide to pick it up, it's on sale until the 28th, marked down 15% with an introductory discount to just $12.74. Alright folks, and as always, here are a few other games to check out while you're already on the eShop. Alright everyone, that's going to go ahead and wrap up today's episode, but keep a lookout for more daily deals and eShop list videos. Thanks again for hanging out, you know you're legendary. If you made it this far, hit that like button, share it around with somebody who might like a deal, and please, stay safe out there.